Now here you can see that context-free languages are describing using context-free grammars. Context-free languages have many applications in programming languages. In particular, most arithmetic expressions are generated by context-free grammars. A context-free grammar is a simple recursive method of specifying grammar rules that can generate strings in a language. Context-free grammar, there is an example of context-free grammar. Here A and B are the variables and 0, 1 and hashes are the terminals. A grammar consists of collections of substitutions rules, that is projections. A is started variables in these cases and usually occur on the left hand side of the topmost, whereas 0, 1 and hashes are the terminals, so it is written in right side. A use of grammar is CFG grammars is used to describe a language by generating each string of languages, where we have to find a variables and a rule which start with that variables, replace written variables with the right hand side of this rule. Repeat the second step until no variable remains. Now in CFG there is a two type symbols, variables and terminals, and two replacement rules, that is LHS and RHS, in which a single variable, that is no terminals, and in RHS there is a string of zero or more variables and terminals. A string consists of only terminals. Now there is a four tuple which is used to define a context-free grammar, that is V, epsilon, R and S, where V are the variables, that is finite set, sigma are the terminal states, R is the setup rules and S is the started variables. S belongs to V. Now what is derivation tree? A derivation tree or a parse tree is an ordered rooted tree that graphically represents the semantic information a string derived from a context-free grammar. There is a representation technique, that is root vertex must be labeled by the start symbol. Vertex second is vertex, that is labeled by a non-terminal symbol, and third is leaves, labeled by a terminal symbol or a epsilon. If a vertex with label A has a children with label x1, x2 up to xn from right to left, then A belongs to x1, x2 up to xn must be production in P. If a vertex has label epsilon, then that vertex is a leaf and the only child of its parents. More generally, a derivation tree can be defined with any non-terminal as a root. Now you can see in the example that here S is a root, A and B are the terminals, and small a is a leaf, and you can also see the yielding grammar, and root can be any non-terminal, leaf nodes can be terminals or non-terminals. A derivation tree with root S shown the production used to obtain a synthetical form. Now for the further PPT, I am calling my group partner.
Okay, thank you Amrit for calling me up. So my name is Ritika Rao and my presentation topics starts with the union of CFGs, which is context-free grammar. So as you can see in the slide, that the new CFG G base X is made as sigma remains the same. SX is the new start variable and V base X, which leads to V1 union V2 union SX. Then is the S and R base X, which leads to R1 union R2 union SX leads to S1 and S2. Then coming to the explanation of this is all we have done is augment the variable set with a new start state and then allow the new start state to map to either of the two grammars. So we will generate strings from either L1 or L2, that is L1 union L2. Then coming to the next slide is about the concatenation of CFGs, which is context-free grammar again. So the new CFG GY here is made again, as we saw in the previous slide, is sigma remains the same. SY is the new start variable. VY equals to V1 union V2 union SY. And RY equals to R1 union R2 union SX, which leads to S1, S2. Again, here the explanation is as same as the previous slide, which is again we all have done here is the augmented the variable set with a new start state and then allow the new start state to map to the concatenation of the two original start symbols. So we'll generate strings that begins with strings from L1 and end with the strings from L2. That is again here L1 and L2. Then comes the clean closure of CFGs, which is the new CFG here is G base Z is made as sigma remains the same. S base Z is the new start variable here in terms of clean closure, and VZ equals to V1 union SZ, and RZ equals to R1 union SZ, which leads to S1, S2 and epsilon. Then again, coming to the explanation here in the terms of clean closure is again, we have augmented the variable set as we did in the earlier slides. And coming to the next slide is about pushdown automata, known as or termed as PDA. So pushdown automata is similar to non-deterministic finite automata, but have an extra element known as stack. So this stack provides extra memory space, which can be termed as the cons of PDA, or could be termed or could be said as an advantage, as it provided as it provide extra memory space. Then is it also allows, which is the stacks allows pushdown automata to recognize some non-regular languages. Then here this illustration would made you easy to clear out the doubt about pushdown automata. Here you can see, as I defined earlier, is a finite automata with straight control with input, and pushdown automata with state control and stack, which provides extra memory space with input. Then is again coming to know about pushdown automata is a pushdown automata PDA can write symbols on the stack and read them back later. So here come again an advantage of PDA and writing a symbol push down all the other symbols on the stack, and only the top symbol in the stack can ever be read, and once read it is removed. So writing a symbol known as pushing and reading a symbol is known as popping. So the PDA has no way of checking for an empty stack. Gets around this by placing a special character, as you can see in the slide, on the stack initially. Then again, if it ever sees that same special character again, it's known as the stack is effectively empty, which is a denotation. Then coming to the very last slide part of mine is some important about PDA, which is deterministic and non-deterministic PDAs are non-equivalent in power. So all, as we know that there are two types of PDAs, which is deterministic and non-deterministic. So here to say that they are not equivalent in power, and non-deterministic PDAs recognize a certain languages which non-deterministic pushdown automata can recognize. So ending with my part of presentation, I would like Ankit Kumar Pandey to continue further. Thank you.
Thank you, Ritika, for inviting me. As my group partners have already discussed about CFL, CFG, and PDA, so now I would like to discuss about the formal definition of PDAs. The formal definition of a PDA is similar to that of an FDA, except for the stack. The stack contains symbols drawn from some alphabet. The machine may use different alphabets for its input and the stack. So we need to specify an input alphabet, sigma, and a stack alphabet, tau. A push-down automata is a six-step, that is Q, sigma, tau, delta, Q naught, and F, where Q, sigma, tau, and F are all finite sets, and Q is a set of states where sigma is the input alphabet and tau is a stack. Now, delta is to Q into sigma E into tau E represents P in the bracket Q into tau E bracket close is a transient function. Then Q naught belongs to Q is a start state, and F which belongs to Q is a set of except states. Now the next topic is context. A language is context-free if and only if sub pushdown automata recognizes. Every regular language is recognized by a finite automata, and every finite automation is automatically a pushdown automation that ignores that stack. We can note that every regular language is also a context-free language. So the next topic is regular and context-free language. As on the screen is given there, the diagram of context-free language and regular language, where context-free language covers regular languages. Now, with this short presentation, I would like to conclude our group presentation with the conclusion that a context-free language is a language generated by a context-free grammar. They are more general and include regular languages. The same context-free language might be generated by multiple context-free grammars. The set of all context-free languages is identical to the set of languages that are accepted by pushdown automata, or even we can call it PDA. Now, a pushdown automation is a way to implement a context-free grammar. In a similar way, we design DFA or a regular grammar. A DFA can remember a finite amount of information, but a PDA can remember an infinite amount of information. Basically, we can say that a pushdown automation is finite state machine plus a stack. So, thank you.
Thank you. Very good presentation. Okay, very good.